General Atomics Aeronautical Systems said it successfully released a new air launch effects platform made with additive manufacturing from the internal weapons bay of an MQ-20 Avenger unmanned system. While the test took place on November 28th, this was disclosed on February 1st. The demonstration was conducted in Dugway Proving Ground, Utah. Observers should be aware that the U.S. military has been thoroughly assessing launched effects for approximately 5 years and is exploring various size classes of such effects. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why MQ-20 Avenger launching advanced air launch effects vehicle is a significant development. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The basic premise is that an unmanned or manned launch platform will themselves launch smaller unmanned vehicles, which would be relatively cheap and would be able to act in a smart way. Dustin Engelhart, Collins Aerospace's senior manager of business development for air launched effects and future tactical UAS, had explained earlier that launched effects are deployed in teams and instructed where to operate and what mission to undertake. Engelhart said each system is aware of what happens to the other systems in the team and can autonomously adapt if one drops off or is shot down. He added that the mission system's autonomy is adaptive, even during a fight that is progressing. The pilot in the manned aircraft could tell the launched effects to change behavior to be more aggressive or operate with extra caution. He said the level of autonomy in the system allows the manned platforms to call for artillery or to potentially command a kinetic strike by the launched effects teams. It really gives a lot of flexibility with limited operator involvement. General Atomics Aeronautical Systems partnered with Divergent Technologies, Inc. to design and build the Advanced Air Launch Effects Vehicle, or A2LE, using Divergent's Adaptive Product System, DAPS, to support rapid, low-cost manufacturing of the demonstration vehicle, it said in a statement. The demonstration showed additive manufacturing, commonly known as 3D printing, early in the design process can create efficiencies, the company said. It represents a crucial stage in the validation of the additive manufacturing process and material characteristics for integration into upcoming systems intended for use in both manned and unmanned platforms. Viewers may note that the MQ-20 has an internal weapons bay capacity of 3,500 pounds, or 1,600 kilometers, a cruise speed of 402 miles per hour, or 648 kilometers per hour, an endurance of 18 hours, and a service ceiling of 50,000 feet, that's 15,240 meters. The company announced that the airframe was exclusively constructed using additive manufacturing. It was specifically designed to meet the captive carriage and ejection loads of the MQ-20. The collaboration enabled the utilization of the Divergent Adaptive Production System, a system developed to design, additively manufacture, and autonomously assemble intricate structures for applications in the automotive, aerospace, and defense industries. Mike Atwood, company vice president of advanced programs, said in the statement, "The flight was a crucial first step in demonstrating GAASI's ability to rapidly develop, manufacture, and test a small unmanned aircraft system, SUAS, in a controlled, low-risk approach. A2LE demonstrates the coupling of GAASI's pedigreed aircraft design capabilities with Divergent's DAPS, paving the way for continued maturation of affordable, modular SUAS platforms that can be tailored to meet warfighter needs at a fraction of the cost and lead time of currently fielded systems. It's evaluating an initial small launched effects prototype, a collaboration between Anduril Industries, RTX's Collins Aerospace, and Aurora Flight Sciences, as it experiments with requirements and capabilities for a future program. General Atomics Aeronautical Systems is planning a network of A2LEs, providing a persistent, expansive grid for surveillance, attack, enemy air defense suppression, or communication pathways, according to the statement, while enhancing current and future manned and unmanned platforms with increased capability. The service plans to launch these small, uncrewed aircraft not only for air platforms, but from launchers on the ground or off vehicles. It has demonstrated the capability several times, including at the service's first Edge exercise in 2021, while experiments with technology to enhance operations in the aerial tier. General Atomics demonstrated another ALE, the Eaglet, that the company deployed from a Gray Eagle UAS a year ago. The Eaglet would fit in the large class, the company said, which translates to having the ability to carry a wide variety of more powerful sensors and payloads. The Gray Eagle would be able to carry it for thousands of kilometers before launching it. A2LE is considered to fit in the small category. There is a lot of potential. C. Mark Brinkley, Chief Global Marketing and Communications Strategist, said, "General Atomics has been approaching the future of uninhabited aerial vehicles and systems from a family of systems approach. Whether air-launched or ground-launched, recoverable or expendable, we see these aircraft as offering different options configured for different missions." Brinkley added that the company is working on several launched effects offerings in addition to Eaglet and A2LE, like Sparrowhawk and Longshot. He said all of these are similar and all of them are different, but the main theme here is affordable mass at scale, attacking a variety of problems in a variety of ways. Brinkley noted, "It wouldn't be fair to compare these aircraft head-to-head at this point because they're all being driven by different requirements and intended uses. But each of these programs is absolutely leveraging best practices and lessons learned from one program to the next to help us iterate and innovate very quickly. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.